it's kind of comical how many times I would stick and not roll away from that trick. Like, not just in the year that I tried it down Brick 9, but like decade plus of trying it down various stair sets all around the world. And I don't know, I've never had a battle like it. And I never expected this to be what I would be doing in like my mid 30s.
Got it, Walker.
It's funny, sometimes it's the distraction that sets you free. Like when you're focused and stuck, like with this varial heel flip, I wasn't coming anywhere close. And that's like the best and worst part about street skating, is you can't control the environment at all. Some people, it drives them crazy, but I kind of love it. Like there was this dude blasting old soul jams. Some like 90s stuff, but a lot of like Aretha Franklin. And he rolled up and was hanging out. And he asked me, like, what would get you hyped? What do you want to hear? And I told him, like, dude, I like what's going on. This is a good vibe. But he was like, no, no, what would get you hyped? And I was like, well, honestly, like, I've been listening to a lot of, like, old Tupac. I was like, yeah, you got Are You Still Down? And he's like, oh, Tupac's my son. I got all his albums. And just that interaction, I don't know if it was knowing the song was going to come on or just getting out of my head even for a second, but boom, it started working. And he didn't just put it on at the volume he'd been playing the rest of the music. He started blasting it. But by the second song, I was rolling away. The first time I actually skated the Brick 9 spot was one evening with Spencer Hamilton. He alley-ooped big flipped over the rail with ease.
Can't believe I rode away from that.
Easy money for you.
I don't know. Did I go over the damn rail?
And feeling inspired and a little big flippy myself, I thought I'd throw a switch one down the 9. It's funny, I never really wanted to skate this spot because I thought the 9 stair seemed like too small, but that evening was inviting. And I can never quite roll away from this trick like the way I want to, but this one happened quickly and I was stoked.
That was it.
See, something happened, always happened.
No. Dude, that was fucked up.
But what I really wanted was a nollie 360 kickflip, but I wasn't feeling confident that day, so I practiced it and came back a few weeks later, got into like a proper battle. And historically, this spot has always been like a super bust, or anytime I've been there, security guards come out right away. And I feel like security guard interactions have been documented across like decades of skate videos. But with the base of the building under construction, the spot became like a free-for-all on weekends.
Oh. Oh.
I'm so sorry, dude. One of the most surprising things I've found about getting into my mid-30s is the amount of new tricks I would learn.
Damn. I thought we were in there, dude.
I never nollie big flip down anything in 25 years of skating, but somehow in my mid-30s, I'm like finally deciding to try it. Even if it's, you know, a small nine stair, it's still nine stair. After getting a nollie big flip, I knew which trick was next in the symmetry of nine stair tricks I needed to piece together. But not wanting to try it yet, I thought I should hem together a line with the two nine stairs. And I went for, you know, the obvious go-to, the 180 and the switch backside flip, which was like surprisingly hard. But being the hot spot that it is, Carl Akins would post a much cleaner version of the same line on Instagram like a few months after I did it. So, knowing I wasn't going to use that, I came back for another combo, similar, but just a little harder. 180, switch big spin. But when I landed it, the filmer didn't press record, and I wasn't able to land another one until a few weeks later. And so began my obsession with the spot we know as Brick 9. The place is like a skate park. There are so many different levels and ways to skate it. I started to piece together in my head like a full part just at this one street corner. There are the two nines. You could skate a line to the nine. There's the wooden rail. Next to the wooden rail is the overledge. There's an outledge. There's a big rail. There's a bigger rail. And of course, the overrail. I even started to tell myself I would step to the scariest flat gap of all time, the one Bryce Golder ollied and Tyshawn tray flipped, which is the most psycho thing. But following the natural symmetry of the nine stair tricks, I knew there could only be one ender. And I knew I had to get that before bothering with any of the other spots at the spot. But this is a trick I'd been trying on stair sets of similar height around the world for over 10 years. One that even in 2022, I had yet to see any other skater do. Shane O'Neill had done one down a small gap, and several other skaters had done them off wedges, but of all the over-the-top flip tricks that have been conquered down stair sets, somehow the switch backside 360 kickflip was still open. So this was a white whale that I've been chasing, but one that I feel like just needed to happen in skateboarding. And, you know, I wanted to be the one to do it.
You could use it.
So like I said, basically every video part, I've tried it on some set somewhere around the world. Never able to roll away. Always able to stick it. So it just became this thing, like, I knew I had to do. Like, there was no getting around it. Like, I had to do this trick. There was no way I was going to be able to live with myself if I didn't finally land this trick. So the second time I went, it was probably 4 hours of trying, never not getting just as close as I had in the beginning. I broke 2 boards, cracked a truck, tweaked my back. It was on my 34th birthday. I was like so determined to give myself that gift of like finally landing this, you know, trick I wanted to hang on my mantle. And I've never been so fucked up from trying a trick, save for like a serious injury. Like I went home and like basically was like nauseous, like physically ill. Like I had to cancel my little birthday party I was gonna have and just like get in bed and wallow. It was awful. So at this point in my life, I'm 34 years old. I've been a pro skater for 11 years, but I'm no longer technically sponsored. My wife Whitney is pregnant with our first child, and a feeling that my life as I had always lived it would soon be coming to an end was dominating my psyche. Meaning my presentation of skateboarding in the form of video parts was no longer supporting me, and thus I couldn't rightly prioritize it over anything else. So, why not enjoy it, these last few months of freedom? Why not try the tricks I can land? Why suffer through the horrible torment of trying a trick that I just might not actually be able to do? I don't know. That's one of the things about skating that make us the most bizarre masochists I've ever come across. The process of trying a new or sometimes old trick is a unique torture that all skateboarders know well. It begins with a feeling of elation and hope and, let's be honest, like, ego. You get close, the confidence soars, and a feeling of, I can do anything, like, takes over. But it doesn't take long for that doubt to slip in, a suggestion in the back of your head that tells you maybe you just can't actually do this thing. Before long, the doubt has transformed into an all-out self-hatred. Not only can you not do this thing, but you can't do anything. You're failing. And your failure at this one little thing is indicative of all the failures in your life. It's really hard to get out of this spiral. This spiral that sends some skaters into all-out rage, some into OCD-infused madness. The smart ones just give up or try something else, knowing it's like not worth it. But somehow for me with this trick, I couldn't stop until I couldn't carry myself back up the stairs. Like, I would sometimes yell, but I wouldn't even get that mad like I usually do. I would just, like, suffer until I just couldn't carry myself back up the stairs. I feel like in skateboarding, we love to kind of oversell failure. That the failure required to get good at skateboarding becomes kind of this, like, metaphor for life. Failure is thus healthy because you pick yourself up. Don't give up. Tell yourself you can accomplish something, even if it's as simple as an ollie or dropping in. And I get it, especially for kids. I use the metaphor all the time. But what happens when you're 34 years old and that failure starts to become kind of all you know when you go skateboarding? That failure starts to represent something else entirely. And it's really hard to not think about all those failings. And it was during another one of these horrible spirals that the man with the speaker rolled up and started playing music. And without saying anything to me, and without me saying anything to him, he just clicked the title track from Tupac's Are You Still Down? And all that failure, all that torment, all that self-hate and doubt just completely disappeared.
Dude, it happened. It fucking happened. It actually happened. All things to my
favor. You did it!
Let's see it!
Oh, was that alright though?
Fuck you!
I'm getting high so a nigga think he touched the sky. Turned up inside.